Everyone, welcome back to my Let's Replay channel. Once again, this is Andrew T coming at you. And today we're going to be doing our vlog review of Abandoned Ship. Now, I played a couple hours after the video that you just saw, so I have a little bit more encompassing opinion now of it other than when I was first playing, and I still like it. It is still in early access, and it is still unfinished with a couple parts that can be definitely be improved. But other than that, I still had a really enjoyable time. Now, just for a breakdown, this is basically FTL at sea, with some Lovecraftian elements in it, some steampunk, some RPG elements. Everything you love about FTL is here. From the crew management, how they level up, the more they use a certain apparatus, or if they use a different one, they can level up with that as well, so you don't have to just have one person be good at one thing. You can move them around, especially during battles. You almost have to do that. So it starts off, like I said, you're a mysterious character in a cult and you escape and then they're chasing you. So that kind of mirrors FTL, where the rebels are after you every screen you go to and you have a certain amount of time before they basically, the armada catches up and kills you. But in this one, you have a timer at the very bottom of the screen that kind of goes to either a Kraken or a really good ship that attacks you at the end of that countdown. Now, you can attack their ships and increase the countdown and get yourself a little bit more time, but if they escape, the countdown can decrease and it can be less time. So it's a good, pretty good balance so far. So you get your ship, you get your crew, and you get out of town, and it shows you the basics of the combat. There are four different, well, technically only three different distances. There's four on there, but one of them, the other ship has to have the other extreme one. So if you just want to use your powerful cannons and just blow the ship up from distance, you can do that, if that's what you want to concentrate on. If you want to close the distance to a little bit closer, that's pretty much the only other option you have. In order to get to something where you can actually hit them with the scatter gun and, you know, attack the crew directly, you have to be almost right next to them. So you have to be at least one square away for that, or you have to, you know, close distance and be, you know, bow to bow with them, or stern to stern, or whatever the case may be. So there's a lot of different options on how you want to attack everyone, but what I found that works the best, and I got this originally from Total Biscuit when he was talking about it on the Co-optional podcast, is that the easiest way to really minimize your damage and to get as much booty as possible from the ship whenever you win the battle is just close the distance, use your gun to get the crew down to a little bit of, you know, half health, for as many as you can, and then, or just ram them and get them off balance, and then have your guys go over and just do hand-to-hand combat, and then have one guy usually take down the sails and one guy always on the navigation. So that way, if you're outnumbered or your guys are getting slaughtered, you can always jump back across to your ship and use a first aid station. So that brings up another thing: the quadrants of your ship. So there are many different things about the ship that are, you know, really close to FTL, but there are also a lot more options depending on the systems you have without the mods in FTL. I know there's a ton of mods out there, but for the basic game, like this one, you have a winch system, so if you get rammed and one of your guys gets knocked out of the sea, you can use that to literally just get them back on the ship without losing them permanently. There's a first aid station, which is like the healing station FTL. You have your weapon mounts, which basically on one side or the other, and that's kind of different from FTL in that you only had one gunner per se that did everything in one station. But this one, you can have multiple people on your four cannons, so you can have two each on them, and they can improve the gunnery cooldown from attacking. So the attacking is just like FTL, where you have the cooldown and it can get shorter and shorter as your eyes get better and better at using them. Also, they have a damage system where, kind of like in FTL, you have the oxygen escaping. This one, you have water coming in. So you repair that, and then you can use your bilge pumps to get the water out of there before it gets to critical, where, you know, your boat's basically about to capsize. What else? There's your mass as well. So if that gets hit, you know, it affects your movement speed. So if you want to close the distance and then they hit your mast, they can gain distance and get away from you, or you can be at a stalemate. So if you both have your masts, and you're trying to close the distance and they're trying to get away, you won't get any closer without first taking down their sails. What else? The story is decent right now. It's pretty bare bones, but it's, you know, for early access, I'm not expecting, you know, a large sweeping epic tale, but for what it is, it's interesting right now. The navigation is pretty good. From where you're going on the map, the Fog of War, like, I upgraded my crow's nest when I went to another port for a larger vision on the screen of Fog of War, so that way I can see more of the map without having to waste as much time or exploring the map area. See, I upgraded my cannons. I had one that does mainly section damage, and I tried to get one that was fire damage. I couldn't afford it. Then I tried to get one that was sniper, but it wouldn't. I didn't have enough for it, which basically attacks one person with major damage. So I think in that one I'm probably going to use, because if you can just destroy the crew from distance, there's really no need to just trade fire for 5 minutes until you close distance. But yeah, I'm really interested in kind of seeing what combinations are out there. I haven't really run into a ton of side quests yet, or not side quests, but random encounters yet. There's been a couple of where you go to one area and it's like there's a couple different outcomes that can happen, just like FTL. So this is very close to FTL in the style of gameplay, with a couple of major tweaks to it and a little bit more content when it comes to your ship and how you can outfit your ship. Okay, so I've talked about the good parts of it. Some of the bad parts that I've found, the navigation on the sections you go to for the map are kind of tedious, in that if you're looking to go through one specific gate and you need one more thing on encounter on the map to open it, and you've been literally everywhere, but there's one section maybe in the bottom left hand corner you haven't been to yet, but it's only about like an inch long, and you go down there and oh, guess what, that's where the last one is. Before I got my crow's nest update, it was really tedious going around the map like 3 or 4 different times trying to find every single one. I think they should, just like in FTL, they should have more encounters than are necessary. That way you're not feeling obligated, like, okay, I want to go through this gate instead of going through the other one, rather than just pigeonholing you into doing every single encounter, whether good or bad. Because there are some out there where I had no choice about that, what the outcome was. I'm like, all right, well, you know, I can investigate it or not. Nope, you lost half your supplies, or you lost 15 of your supplies. I'm like, well, I guess that was technically an encounter, so I can go through the gate now. But there's no way you can really right now pick and choose the encounters you want to do. If you want to get through a specific gate with the most on there, you have to do every single encounter. And if the Kraken attacks you, that does not count as an encounter. So if you're waiting around for that, or possibly the big pirate ship is an encounter, if you get that one, but if you get the Kraken, you can get it 3 or 4 times. And, you know, the Kraken's not very hard once you get about 5 crew members, because at that point you have one for almost every single tentacle that attacks you, and it takes literally about 4 or 5 seconds to get them off, and then you can just escape. But it just gets kind of tedious at that point. Like, all right, the Kraken's here, I'll just spend 5 minutes fighting it and then be on my way, and then the timer resets. So I'm not sure what the New Game Plus is going to be like. Like I said, it's still in early access. So there's a lot of good in this game and hardly any bad right now. If they tweak these little things, it'll be a great game whenever it finally rolls out for its day one distribution there. But for right now, it's definitely early access. There's still a little bit of tweaking to do, but I'm really interested to see what the finished product is going to be. So if I had a score right now, I'd give it an 8 out of 10, easy. Just because it's almost finished, it's almost completely finished now. It's enjoyable as FTL. They've pretty much a spiritual successor, in my opinion. All the mechanics on it are solid. If they just fix a couple things, it'll definitely get about up to a 9 if they do those tweaks. So, thank y'all so much for watching. Once again, this is Andrew T coming at you, and what a great day for a replay. Y'all have a good one.